What's up guys, MakeNoise UK here and welcome to episode 5 of Car Mechanics Simulator 2015. And you might have noticed that I have got a lot more experience than I did at the end of the last episode. I think I had about 800. But yeah, the reason why I've got more is because I've done more jobs, obviously, that's how you earn XP. But the reason why I did more jobs is because I sort of realised how long it would take to progress to where what I want to actually do in this series. So yeah, what I actually want to do in this series is buy my own cars and fix them up and either sell them on or keep them, whatever. You know, restoring cars, that's what I want to do in this series. But to do that, you obviously need to buy cars, and to buy cars, you need to go to the auction centre here. But first, you need to buy a parking, some parking spaces. So I were actually gonna do this. This is how I realised how much I would need to do. I will look into it, and then I saw that you need to buy a parking space, so I went over here. Try to buy the parking space, but I need 9,000 XP, and as you can see at the minute I've got 1,500, so that's a long way to go. So then obviously 9,000 XP, I realised how many cars I would have to fix up to get to that much experience, and you know, I do about a couple of cars an episode, so that's going to be a lot of episodes. So that's why I did a few cars while I worked recording. I've got 1,500 experience, and now I decided to record a new video. Firstly, because I can buy an upgrade, and also because let me go on my phone here. I can do this job that needed 1,500 experience. So I thought this would be a good place to start. You know, the next episode. By explaining this and stuff and doing this car. I'm not too sure if there's anything special about it, but yeah, it's just, that's a nasty, nasty colour that is. Wow. I would want to change that colour. So I've got a few jobs here. Crankshaft, intake oil filter, spark plug, and then replace the oil. It says the oil filter. Oh, the oil filter. Yeah, it says the oil filter twice, which is a bit weird. But yeah, I've got. This will be from a job that I did off camera. I did about 4 off camera to get as much experience. But yeah, but before I start that, I'm gonna buy my first upgrade. As you can see, upgrade points available 1. And we can buy, well, any one of these. I'm not too sure if this is the best one to go for at the start, but it will save a lot of time, fast unbolting. So I'm going to go for that one. I really, you know, unbolting is really, really tedious and annoying in this game, so I'm going to increase the speed of that. Tablet would have been good, but I can get that next. So yeah, let's get fixing this car. So it's obviously going to be on the engine. Let's just quickly examine. Yeah, we've got the air filters down there, intake manifold, and then the crankshaft stuff is down here. What is it? The crankshaft bearing cap, pulley, intake manifold, and the spark plug. You have to get under there to get to the spark plug. But yeah, let's start taking things off. Oh, you have to get the oil filter under the car. How annoying is that? But yeah, let's just start here then, I guess. So just take the throttle off, intake manifold. Let's see how quicker this is. Oh, that's much better. Wow, that's going to save a lot of time. Glad I bought that. Get in. I guess I'll just get the spark plug, whichever one it is. I'm going to have to take them all off anyway, so. All the ignition coils. Engine head. super speed screwdriver, man. Whatever we're using here. Probably a screwdriver, I don't really know. Maybe a wrench. Which spark plug is it? Let's see if we can tell. This one. I'm similar. I want to go on dissimilar mode. There we go. Now the crankshaft stuff. And then we'll do the oil filter in a minute. Afterwards. I'm just gonna go in there because I've got a bad view. if I can get. Right. This should be better, I hope. That's a bit better. Take off the belts. There's quite a few things to take off here, actually. And also, if I was just going back to what I was saying earlier, if I was gonna do every single car, record every single car, then it'll get a bit repetitive as well. I'll have to, be a lot of the same things that we're changing and a bit same commentary. So I thought this would be a better thing to do. So I think the crankshaft bearing cap is under the car, so we're going to put that on the lifter, and yeah, let's go take it off now, and the oil filter, everything, put it up, back on the lifter, suspension, we're going to take off the oil filter and the oil pan to get to the bearing cap, I think. And this is actually the quickest way to change the oil instead of draining it with the drain plug thing there, fetching that pan thing over. This is just a quicker and easier way to do it. But yeah, which one is it? It's this one here, that bearing cap. Get that. And then I think that's we've took off every part, so we need a bearing cap, a pulley, intake manifold. Yeah, I'm going to probably. Where am I? Oh, it's this way. I'm gonna have to keep checking because I'll forget all that. So let's go. Crankshaft. So we need crankshaft bearing cap and crankshaft pulley. I guess it's just the R4. Intake manifold. Which one is it? I'm gonna have to look. Which one do we take off? R4DI. Let's just check, see if we've got this. Right. Crankshaft pulley R4. Crankshaft bearing cap. Yeah. Did I buy that? Crankshaft pulley. Yeah, it's there. Damn it. Intake manifold R4DI. This one, spark plug, what the hell is that, spark plug, there we go, $6, and then the oil filter, R4, and I think that is everything, so let's go put it all back on. We'll start with the underneath. Assemble mode, bearing cap, come on, gotcha, put the new one on, screw it in, put the oil filter on here, just make sure it's ticking it off, yep, oil pan, a few screws, where's this one, can I get it, damn it, can't see it, ah, it's here. Ah, still didn't get it all the way in. What an idiot. Now, put it back down on the floor, I think. I think we've done everything underneath. Come back down. And yeah, let's start going in here. Guess we'll start over here. Assemble mode. Crankshaft pulley. See if it's ticked that off as well. Yep. And then put all these wire things back, well, belts, wires. What am I on about wires? go. And the final belt. Not wire. I think that's everything down there. And the new intake manifold. A few screws here. It doesn't really matter as much anymore because we've got a faster one, which is a lot better, obviously. As it ticked that off, it has, and this throttle here just slots on nice. What? Slots on nicely. That spark plug. And then it should have ticked that off as well. Yes, it has. So let's just put that back on. A few screws, damn it. I wish you could upgrade it again. Already. Still not quick enough, come on. It is better, but it's not quick enough, still. So put that on. Dead one. Dead one. And dead one. And then... That's it, right? That's everything. So now we just need to change the aisle. Actually, now I have to do it now. I'm not as stupid as I were last episode or wherever it were. Because I have had to change it a few times off camera. But yeah, I think that is everything. Tick, tick. $1,067. We have done that job nice and easy. Yeah, let's see what other jobs we've got here then, I guess. Phone. 3,000 XP for that. 4,522. That's a bit random, isn't it? That's moving on to the exhaust. We haven't done any exhaust stuff yet. But yeah, what are these? Find and fix any running gear problems, sloppy car steering, general running gear control and repair. Do this one, this sounds easier. And there's a... Well, it seems like there's less things to do, so I might as well do this one. And get that XP up. I'm not sure where I'll start the next episode, to be honest, not XP and stuff. But we'll see. Come on, this just takes ages. Right, here we go. So let's just have a quick look what we need to do. Front drive axle, front sway bar, rear suspension, rubber bushing, sway bar, rear end link. A lot of suspension stuff there, so we're going to have to obviously move it onto the lifter. I'm just going to sell all this stuff here. We don't need it anymore. Power filter and the bearing cap, make a few bucks, and then the phone's going again. Pull it up. We'll do the front first and then the back. Easier way instead of getting confused. It's just going to be, you know, I wish it told you where this rubber bushing and the front are here. But it doesn't, so you know, whatever. And the seat, oh my god. Rusty. Rusty stuff, just make sure that there's no stuff on that side. Make sure there is. So let's go from both sides. Okay then, let's get to work. I'm gonna have to actually take the wheel off. Just inevitable really. There we go. Take the drive axle. So I'm going to take this off first. And that. And that. What? Why is it zooming in on its own? What do I need to take? Oh, do I need to take the other side off? Are you serious? Damn it. Well, I guess it doesn't really matter. Seeing as there's something on this side as well. Oh, it's just that. Alright. Fair enough. I'm really not sure where this rubber bushing is. I'm hoping it's on the back. Sway bar. Take that off, then we can take the other thingy off. And then I think that's it for the front, maybe. Let's just have a quick look. So we've done two things, front. Let's just see if there's, if we can see three things that need to be repaired on the back. Let's go into this. One there, obviously. Another one there. And that's it. god. It's gonna be that rubber bushing. It's gonna take a while. Well, I'm not gonna find it. Damn it. Yeah, let's just go. Wait. I'm just gonna check what it is we need to buy. And let's buy it for the front. Front drive axle, front sway bar. Front drive axle, front sway bar. Drive axle. Front drive axle. Oh, I didn't even check which one it is, A, B, or C. Damn it. C and just the normal sway bar. Drive axle C and then just the normal sway bar. Front drive axle C and then sway bar. Front sway bar. There we go, let's fit them on. I'm not going to put the wheels on. Sway bar, and then the thingy, end link, screw on, and then to the other side, the other thingy, the other end link, whatever it's called, that we had to put on to take the sway bar off, thermal mode, and there we go, couple screws. I prefer doing engine work than suspension work. It's because there's a lot more of it and it's really hard to see where everything is. I'm just going to see if we can... Oh wait. Is that the rubber bushing? Yes, we found it. Thank god I started to look. Rubber bushing. One screw. Let's go buy it quickly. Rubber bushing. Thank god I started to look for that, otherwise I would have never have found it. Well, it would took me a long time. Rubber bushing. Rubber bushing, $15. Let's go fit it. And move on to the back. This bit, why is it zoom out when it's on? Is it just me and my silly poor skills? A new one, please, and then fit. There we go. Right onto the back. Let's start with this side. Obviously, that is what we need to take off. That we need to take off that. Is that it? Yeah. Suspension arm. There we go. And onto the other side. Things like you do. Is that it? Yep. Nice and easy. So we need a sway bar rear end link and a rear suspension arm. Sway bar rear end link, rear suspension arm. Let's just put sway bar rear end link and suspension arm, I think. Is that where it were? Rear suspension arm. Damn it, I'm gonna. rear suspension. Yeah, it's just the normal one. Rear suspension arm, $175, man. Quite expensive, that, actually. But we will get more money afterward anyway, so it's fine. Suspension. Why? How the hell did I click that? Assemble mod, let's put it back on. Yes. A new one, please, obviously. I'll do the wheel in a minute. And then over here, assemble mod. Rear suspension arm. Three screws. There we go. And then the bushing. And then we have to put all the wheels back on. Let me just check, stick them all off, and it has. Thank god for that. Wheels time. I'm just gonna put it on the floor, it makes it easier. In my opinion. The this one first. Zimmer mod from Classic. Oh, why don't you want them wheels cleaned up? They look nasty. I really don't understand that. How do they even get that bad anyway and not need replacing? That's just weird. Let's see if this one's the same. This is 65%. And it's pretty much all rusty. Weird. Now the last one. This one. 65% again, and it's obviously all rusty. What is with this? Alright, that should be it, shall we? $792. There we go. Done and dusted. We've nearly got enough for another upgrade. We've got 1,700. We need 2,000. I'll probably buy the tablet next. Fast assembly, disassembly. I wonder what that does. Obviously, it assembles quicker, but. Oh, it's just the things that don't need screwing and go on quicker, I guess. Fast manual examination. So you can see what needs replacing quicker. I guess we have taken things off first to be able to find them. Oh yeah, I think the tablet will be the most useful for the next thing. What we've got next? Poor brake quality for performance. But yeah, I think that'll probably be it for this episode. So yeah, obviously this episode we just did the Carlet needed the XP and bought his upgrade. Progression. But yeah, and I'm not sure when I'll see you in the next episode, but where we'll be, how much experience and stuff. But yeah, we'll find out. Hopefully I'll be closer to buying the parking thing. I'm just going to check how much we need for this. Path test, 2,500, not as much. 5,000, so that is actually the most. I think that's 6,000, right? Oh, 9,000, wow. That is by far the most. But yeah, obviously it's the best because you can buy your own cars in, which is what I want to do. But yeah, thanks for watching this episode. Like the video if you enjoyed and subscribe if you want more. And I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye. I think he just basically the same as last time, but jumped down in there. Not really sure where the piston combo is, but we'll should find it in here, I'm guessing.